Georgina, if I may just kick off, please. We've just been told by the manager about N'Golo testing positive for coronavirus and having to quarantine. So I wondered if you could maybe give us your reaction to that. I mean, he had a seizure some time ago in the training ground. He was also very worried when COVID first appeared, and he stayed away from training. So it's a kind of a particular case. But also, I wonder if you could talk to us about players and their views on getting jabbed, because it's a big topic of conversation. Where you stand on it, please.
Yeah, this is just like really new. We just knew this morning, and to be honest, at the moment, I'm thinking about the game tomorrow and this personal thing. Everyone has choice, so I'm not going to that, to be honest with you.
Cheers, Andy. Going to move on to James Robson.
Hi, Georgina.
Yes.
We saw in the summer Italy's defence that pairing they have is about as tough as there is in world football. How can you tell us a bit about what makes them such a daunting challenge, and also how Chelsea can get at them? Is Romelu the ideal person to go at them?
Sorry, I didn't understand.
Can you just repeat it again? Sorry.
Sorry, can you repeat, please?
The whole question.
Yeah,
Yeah,
please.
the Italy defence, we saw in the summer how strong that was. What makes them such competitors? How will Chelsea hurt them? But is Romelu the perfect person for that?
How are we gonna try to hurt them? I'm not gonna tell you. But obviously, tactically, they are really strong. They know how to defend the box, because they are very organized. Juventus is a big club, and they've been there for many years. And we need to try to break them by speed, energy. And we know it's gonna be difficult. We respect them, but we're gonna try to win.
Good, cheers. We're going to move on to James at TalkSport.
Jorginho, what do you think went wrong against Manchester City on Saturday? And what have you got to get right tomorrow in Turin to get a result?
Yeah, maybe we were a bit passive in the defensive side from everyone, and then we need to accept that they were pressing very well. And they did a great job, so we need to learn from that and try to make better next time.
Next up, Jacob.
Hi, Jorginho. And
Hello.
just to continue from that, the manager said was just before that he wondered if he got the system wrong on Saturday. Was that something that you felt as a team when Manchester City were putting you under such pressure with their pressing when you
Yeah,
had the ball?
maybe we didn't have the best choice trying to escape the pressure. The pressure was very high, and then they were pressing very well. We couldn't find the space between lines, trying to get out of the press. And then maybe we were running a lot behind the ball, and then we couldn't think that much to get out of that pressure. Yeah, I think maybe we didn't get the best choice.
Good, cheers. And we're going to go on to the last question now, which is for Rami. If you want to unmute yourself, please.
Hello, Jorginho, can you hear
Hello.
me?
Yeah, good to go.
Yeah, you've had a really busy summer. Played the Champions League final, gone to play the Euro, come back and fitter it. How do you feel physically, and you think you can go the long haul, or you feel that at some point you need management?
What do you mean? I don't understand that.
So you're saying
I
you've had a very busy summer. How do you feel physically?
Yes, we had like loads of games, a lot, and everyone at some point, of course. We can feel all those games because there is no time to train, there is no time to rest. But you need to push, you need to play. We just try to keep pushing to work harder. But of course, it's very difficult for all these games we have in a short period of time.